Weather plays a major role in every pilot's career, especially for those flying for the airlines. Being prepared to handle challenging conditions is a critical skill. In order to fly safely in all types of weather, pilots need the right training, ratings, and a clear understanding of when and where they're allowed to fly. In this video by Epic Flight Academy, we're breaking down the difference between VFR and IFR, what they mean, how they affect your flight privileges, and how you can earn each rating. If you're working towards your pilot goals, or an aviation lover looking to learn something new, make sure you like this video and subscribe to Epic Flight Academy for more aviation tips and insights. Let's get started. VFR and IFR are two very important sets of rules that govern how pilots operate and navigate their aircraft. Let's start with VFR, which stands for Visual Flight Rules. Under VFR, pilots navigate using visual cues outside the aircraft, like roads, landmarks, and bodies of water. Because they're relying on what they can see, VFR pilots must consistently scan the area for other aircraft and be prepared to react quickly to avoid potential conflicts. Weather plays a major role in VFR flying, since visibility is key. Pilots must be alert for sudden changes that could reduce visibility or create hazardous conditions. That's why VFR flights typically take place on clear days, with stable weather and good visibility. When flying under visual flight rules, pilots must follow specific criteria set by the FAA to ensure safety and compliance. These rules center around visibility, distance from clouds, and the ability to avoid bad weather. Pilots operating under VFR must always stay within legal weather minimums. There are no exceptions. For example, visibility must be at least 3 statute miles, aircraft must stay at least 500 feet below clouds, 1,000 feet above them, and 2,000 feet away horizontally. These standards help prevent flying into dangerous conditions. When weather meets these visibility and distance minimums, it is considered visual meteorological conditions. If the weather falls below these thresholds, it is classified as instrument meteorological conditions and requires a different set of procedures. To guide pilots, the FAA outlines clear requirements that every VFR flight must follow, including fuel requirements, a VFR flight plan, basic VFR weather minimums, special VFR weather minimums, VFR cruising altitude or flight level, and special awareness training. Instrument flight rules, or IFR, are essential for pilots who want to fly in low visibility and complex weather conditions. More than half of all private pilots go on to earn their instrument rating because of the increased safety, skill, and flexibility it provides. IFR pilots are trained to stay ahead of the aircraft at all times, enhancing their decision-making and ability to manage changing situations. Under IFR, pilots don't rely on visual references. They depend fully on instruments, communication with air traffic control, and their ability to remain focused and calm in the cockpit. ATC plays a key role in helping IFR pilots navigate effectively, often adjusting flight paths to avoid rough weather and ensure smooth operations. Certified Flight Instrument Instructors, or CFIIs, provide hands-on training both in simulators and in the aircraft, sometimes using a view-limiting device known as a hood. Pilots learn how to fly by reference to instruments alone, and when it's safer to remain grounded. The training concludes with a written exam and a check ride to demonstrate proficiency. IFR flight also comes with specific FAA regulations covering aircraft lighting and systems, especially during night operations. To operate safely and legally under IFR, pilots must be trained in the following: fuel requirements, IFR flight plan and pre-flight preparation, VOR equipment check, IFR flight plan filed with air traffic control, IFR takeoff and landing visibility limitations, minimum altitudes and distances for IFR operations, IFR flight levels, altitudes, and cruising speeds, flight path clearances, IFR communications and communication failures, IFR malfunction reporting in controlled airspace, special airspace general operating procedures. IFR flights, especially at night, require specific lights, including position lights, anti-collision lights, and potentially a landing light as outlined in FAA regulations. and closing flight plan after completed flight. In modern training aircraft, you will typically find a glass cockpit with a G1000. This contains the instrument panel of an aircraft that uses electronic flight instrument displays on large LED screens and has a built-in GPS. Pilots prefer them over more traditional analog instruments or six-packs. Airlines rely on glass cockpits like these found in Epic's training aircraft to free up pilots' attention to focus on the most pertinent information. Glass cockpits support both VFR and IFR flights and typically replace the need for a flight engineer. Here are some of the benefits for both VFR and IFR. The benefits of glass cockpits for VFR flights are enhanced situational awareness, real-time airspace alerts, flight path tracking, and redundancy. The benefits of glass cockpits for IFR are integrated flight instruments, autopilot integration, instrument approach overlays, and weather and terrain awareness. As a pilot, you will grow and learn the most when mistakes are made. Thankfully, that's why it takes so long to become a pilot. Much of your time is spent training so that when you do finally become a licensed pilot, you are proficient enough and confident enough to correct your mistakes and remain safe. Here are some of the most common mistakes VFR and IFR pilots make. The most common mistakes by VFR pilots are flying into instrument meteorological conditions. Also known as VFR into IMC, this occurs when a VFR-only pilot flies into weather conditions with poor visibility, such as clouds, fog, or heavy rain without being instrument rated. This is so dangerous because the pilot loses visual references to the horizon. Spatial disorientation sets in rapidly, often in under 3 minutes. Many accidents occur when pilots try to push through deteriorating weather. To avoid this, use thorough weather briefings and tools like ADS-B weather. Always have an alternate route or an escape plan, and respect personal and legal weather minimums. The most common mistakes by IFR pilots are failure to maintain situational awareness. In complex or high workload environments, IFR pilots may misunderstand ATC instructions, miss a step in an approach procedure, enter incorrect data into the flight management system, or fail to monitor aircraft performance while focused on the instruments. This is risky because it can lead to altitude or course deviations, missed approaches or navigation errors, or even controlled flight into terrain if situational awareness is lost. To avoid this, use proper briefing techniques and checklist discipline. Maintain a mental model of position and intent. Monitor automation closely. In other words, don't overtrust it. About half of all weather-related general aviation accidents happen when pilots continue flying under VFR into poor weather. Additionally, most of those accidents are fatal, according to the AOPA. This means that about 36% of all weather-related events involve fatal VFR into IMC accidents. When it comes to flying either VFR or IFR, the most important thing for a pilot to do is monitor and respect the weather. For Epic specifically, we know weather can change in an instant. Being prepared for sudden changes in weather and knowing how to handle those changes are what separate the good pilots from the great ones. Thank you for watching. Be sure to like this video if you learned something new today, and make sure you subscribe for more aviation tips and insights from Epic Flight Academy.